Hallo, was?
Yes.
Der kleine Ding.
Der kleine Ding, ja. Bing, bing, Jesu. Kape, ini kasut lawa.
Super lama, ya.
Welcome back to another episode of...
You don't have a name for this show yet! Woo!
Okay. Welcome back. How was Melbourne?
That was good. It was very cold. Even though it was hot, but it was cold. Like Katy Perry.
Anyways, what are we going to talk about today? I forgot.
I mean, clearly you can see the box. It is a Boost box. It is a Yeezy box. And then you can see this Yeezy. So I think if you're smart enough, you can probably relate.
Yeah. So we are... You want to open the box now?
Yeah. Alright.
Look at that. Look at that.
Okay, you guys, I really like
this. This is really, really nice.
This is damn nice.
The reason why we had that really ugly looking... Okay, it's not ugly. It's just really dirty.
Well worn. Well loved.
Well loved.
Free love.
You can put it back up on the table. Is to make a comparison between the V1 and the V2. Personally, I like the V2 this colorway. So far, all the other colorways that Kanye's been teasing, I don't really like it. This is the only one that I like. But the V1's definitely been like straight up fire, whatever colorway. Even the mauve colorway is very nice also. It looks nice.
Yeah, that one I think is a hit or a little bit.
Not bad. I mean, you get easy to match lah.
Probably the cheapest 700 out there.
Really? Right now? How much?
1000.
Oh really?
Oh, 950.
Below retail?
Yeah.
Wow.
Brand new.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay, what are your thoughts, man?
What are my thoughts? So I really like this shoe because one thing is the 3M with that stripes thingy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, if under flash when you take a photo, right, it's just like bright. Like, another thing I really like about this, like, it looks like an iceberg. You know, like you go to North Pole or something like that, then you see like...
What were you high on when you were...
I don't know, but it's really nice.
Just a comparison of how, a side-by-side comparison, is how different the shoe is right now. Small, subtle changes.
Yeah, the midsole is the same.
Pretty much the same, no difference.
No, it's the same.
It's the same.
Yeah,
it's just the upper, the panelings are different. Yeah. They added an extra panel here on top. And then...
they removed this entire side part.
Yeah.
Just to make a full in the back.
And then this, the three stripes is over here. The back, it's very different as well. I really, really like, I'm in love with this one. But I'm like full on regretting not putting the trigger on this. Seeing this up close, this is really nice.
Yeah. But one thing that, if you guys were wondering if you wanted to buy one, it's like at first look and then it's just like, oh shit. Like, one thing you have to take note is that the mesh is way thicker on this compared to this.
So, would that affect sizing?
Actually, this one, I don't know. For me, it fits a little bit snugger.
Wow, new word. You learned that in Australia or what?
Yeah, mate.
Okay, so one thing to know, the characteristics of this shoe is it's very wide. But when the front part is very, like, really flat here, you can see the front is quite flat.
It's that shape, man, the trainer shape.
Yeah, so it's really sharp. But because it wants to maintain that sharp look, the front is really short. So when you, if you have like fat toes like me, I don't know whether you...
Quite fat.
So when you go in, right, it will be very tight here lah, in the front part of the toe box.
The starting will be tight lah.
Yeah. To be honest, I think the only silhouette that is really making waves right now is the Wave Runner lah.
Really?
Pun intended lah. Like all the other Yeezy silhouettes, like the 350s. I think Kanye should just slow down on the 350s. Stop crying out loud, like for real. Slow down. Stop restocking your stuff and focus on quality over quantity. But then again, he did say everyone would get
a pair of
Yeezys. Yeah, so
he's
keeping to his word, and like, no hate, but you know, maybe you should do more colorways instead of restocking as well. You know, when we first saw it, When he was coming out of his Calabasas office in this, and everyone was raving about the shoe, it was teased like so long ago, and it finally made a real general drop when last year, like late, second half of last year, right?
Yeah.
So they had like, imagine a girl teasing you for a year, and then one year. After a while, you also like,
do I really want this?
So you find a better version. One thing to note that the price of the 700s are like really high. 1,400 for retail. Okay, one thing's for sure, I'm still very old school, okay? I will never pay more than $1,000 for a pair of shoes. Like, I really don't like paying more than $1,000. So, usually we end the show with our rating of this shoe. How much would you rate this?
This solid 8.5, bro. Solid. I feel like this was made for me. The moment I tried this on, I just like, thank you, Kanye. Like, legit, this is damn nice.
In an alternate universe where the price point was way cheaper, I would give this a 10 out of 10.
Wow!
And just because it is expensive, I would give this a 9. Because I love the colorway, it's really, you know, up my alley, it's like white-ish. Nice, yeah. It's comfortable, it's stylish, you can really rock this with anything. It offers such a good look. So I think this is a 9 out of 10. Like, Kanye, you're a genius.
This one, legit.
Okay,
so if you like this review, give it a like. Give it a like, even if you don't like, give it a like for effort, okay? Share this video, comment down what you think about this shoe. Do you think the price point is too high? And whether you actually cop this instead of this, or you can do a comparison yourself. You read it. We actually read your comments.
Yep.
So yeah, don't be shy. So okay, signing out, I'm Julian.
Ryan here, thank you.
Thank you, okay.
See you guys.
See you guys.